Hello everyone, my name is Zenitsu and I'm back with another Digimon deck profile video. So today I'm going to be taking a look at what you could do with purple on a budget, just because there are a whole bunch of really powerful cards that they got in BT04, on top of which they also did get a new starter deck. So purple definitely looks to be like one of the stronger colors to be playing on a budget, as long as you could get your hands on at least 1 to 2 copies of the starter deck. So going over the deck, starting with the Digitama, I'm going to be running 1 copy of Yaman. So Yaman is the 5th Digitama. This could really be anything you feel like, but I just like what Yaman is doing because he has this nice inheritable ability where during your turn, while you have 5 or more cards in your trash, this Digimon gains plus 1000 DP. Purple isn't really known for having lots of ways to consistently DP boost their Digimon, so the fact that we have Yaman to allow us to try to increase our Digimon's DP definitely really helps, especially if we want to hit into the security, especially if we want to hit into the security with multiple security checks. But the main Digitama of the deck is going to be Demimaramon. So Demimaramon is still just an absolutely insane Digitama to be working with, and is probably still Purple's best at Digitama, just because he has this really good inheritable ability of on delete, you get to draw 1 card and then discard 1 card. So this is just really good because looting is better than just straight up milling, because at milling you don't get to choose what's going to go into your trash, but with looting not only are you just drawing cards getting through your deck faster, but you also get to pick what cards you're going to be discarding. So that's just what makes Demimaramon absolutely insane, just because of how much consistency this type of ability brings to the deck overall. Next, on to the rookies, I'm going to be running 2 copies of Tapirmon. So Tapirmon is still just a really good rookie to be playing around with because he has this nice on-delete ability of allowing us to draw 1 card. So this is really good for not only just being a sacrificial fodder card, but it's really good at trying to aggress into the opponent's security, so that way we have multiple different ways of trying to delete this card to get the benefit of drawing a card with. Next, I'm going to be running 4 copies of Candlemon. So Candlemon is a pretty decent Digimon to be working with, just because he is that value-efficient Digimon, where he has a low play cost, low Evo cost, and some relatively decent DP in comparison to everything else in his level, all just making him a very fantastic tempo tool. Next, I'm going to be running 2 copies of Gazimon. So Gazimon is also another really important card, just because he has a really powerful ability where during all turns, your opponent can't gain memory except by tamer effects. So this is a really powerful of an ability to be playing around with, just because so many colors are trying to manipulate the memory in different ways. Not all of it's through their tamers. So Gazimon just takes all of those memory manipulating shenanigans and throws it out the window as long as he's on the field. And limiting what actions that your opponent can be doing as a result is still just a really, really powerful ability to be playing around with. Next, I'm going to be running 2 copies of Ghostmon. So Ghostmon is really only in the deck just because we are playing with a tiny bit of Digiburst synergy. So sometimes we want Ghostmon, sometimes we don't. But the times that we do want Ghostmon, he can be pretty good just because he has this nice inheritable ability where during your turn, when this card is trashed due to the Digimon using their Digiburst ability, then you get to return this card to your hand instead. So the thing that like has me mixed on why I like Ghostmon but why I don't like Ghostmon is the fact that with Kreskurumon from the starter deck, we want to fill up our trash. So Digibursting our rookie just allows us to replay our rookie based on Kreskurumon's ability, which I'll get to later on in the video. So that's kind of why I like it. But at the same time, if you already have better options in your trash to pick from, then having Ghostmon just add itself back to your hand so that way you could figure out a way to replay it later is also still really good. So between the two, I'm kind of mixed on why I like and don't like Ghostmon, but I still think that he's very important and very valuable for the deck. And then the last rookie of the deck is going to be 4 copies of Labramon. So Labramon is really good because she has this nice on-play ability of allowing us to draw 1 card and discard 1 card. So as I mentioned before, looting is just really good, and the fact that we have Labramon to help us loot just makes Labramon super valuable for the deck. Next, on to the champions, I'm going to be running 4 copies of Meramon. So Meramon is really only in the deck just because he evos for 1. So that's all we care about, is just using him as a good stepping stone to try to get into him and get off of him as fast as we possibly can. Next, I'm going to be running four copies of Garurumon. So this is the Garurumon from the starter deck, and really I'm only playing this Garurumon just because he has a play cost of four. So any of the other cards that have a play cost of four, you could feel free to replace them with, but I just feel like compared to all of the others, what he's doing at least could add a lot more value to the deck, just because he has this nice inheritable ability of when attacking, you get to draw one card and discard one card. So again, this type of ability is just really good because it's just helping the overall consistency of the deck. The reason why I'm not super thrilled with the Garurumon is just because these slots that we want to be digi-bursting away first are going to be our rookies and champions, and we generally would rather keep our ultimates and eggs because they could have more impactful and more powerful abilities on them, but we still want an ability to be playing around with it just in case we are caught in the off chance where we need to keep our champion underneath our Digimon. So I just feel like Garurumon is still just a really good card to be playing with as a result for all of those reasons. And then the last champion of the deck is going to be four copies of Devimon. So this version of Devimon comes from the starter deck, and this Devimon is really, really good because he is fulfilling multiple different roles all at the same time. The first role that he's fulfilling is he is the deck's dedicated blocker, so that's just already looking to be pretty good. Just having a blocker in the deck just allows you to be somewhat defensive, and then on top of which he also evos for one, so if we really need to use him as a tempo tool, then he is a really good tempo tool to be playing with as well. Next, on to the ultimates, I'm going to be running two copies of Weregarurumon. So this is the BT-02 version of Weregarurumon, and this card is absolutely insane for the deck just because of all of the combo potential this card has. So what this card is doing is he has the nice inheritable ability of when attacking once per turn, you get to delete one of your other Digimon to unsuspend this Digimon. So this is really good because we could combo it with Crescurumon to use Crescurumon's ability to res a Digimon, then swing, then use the resed Digimon as fodder for this ability to basically get a restand and swing again. So this is just a really powerful card to be playing around with it just because it could help the overall damage output of the deck. Next, I'm going to be playing four copies of Skullmerimon. So Skullmerimon is a really good card to be playing it just because it is a tempo efficient card where whether we need to hard play it or digivolve into it, we really don't care just because it is more efficient than any of the other level 5s we could be playing. So I really like what this card is doing because some really good plays is we could just hard play a Skullmerimon, then go into an Anubismon right afterward, or we could digivolve all the way up into Crescurumon, and because he doesn't have any abilities, we're free to use him as good digiburst fodder, all depending on what the stack of Crescurumon is looking like. So I really like all of the utility and versatility of how we could utilize this card, thus making him a really good card to be playing. And then the last ultimate of the deck is going to be two copies of Weregarurumon. So this is the Weregarurumon from the starter deck, and I really like this card as well, just because he has a nice inheritable ability where during your turn, while there are five or more cards in your trash, then this Digimon gains plus 2000 DP. So this is just another way Purple has at DP boosting their Digimon, and again, DP boosting in Purple is rather rare, so that just makes this card a really standout card to be playing with already, because if we pair this buff up with Yamon, that's plus 3000, and if we put that on Crescurumon, then he could hit some really high numbers. So I really like the flexibility on the different abilities, but you could kind of customize the deck based on what you feel like you want to be playing around with, but I really just do like what this card is doing as a whole. Next, on to the Megas, I'm going to be running three copies of Anubismon. So Anubismon for an uncommon in BT-04 is absolutely insane. So what this card is doing is it has a really powerful when digivolving ability where you get to play a level 3 Digimon from your trash for free. So just that first part of the ability is really good because it doesn't say it's color locked, and you also get the on play ability if it does have one. So this is what makes Labramon really, really extra powerful for the deck, just because you could replay Labramon and get its on play ability off, but you could also apply this to so many other cards and figure out so many different other uses for how to maximize this ability. And then on top of which, you also have another ability where during your turn, when you play a Digimon from your trash, that Digimon gains Rush for the turn. So Rush basically just allows the Digimon to attack the same turn it comes into play, making anything you res as long as Anubismon is on the field very aggressive, and that level of aggression could help close out games even faster. So I really do love what Anubismon is doing, and I do think he is one of the more powerful Megas you could be playing with on a budget. But the main mega of the deck is going to be 4 copies of Kreskurumon. Keep in mind that the starter deck only does come with 2 copies, so it's recommended that you get 2 copies of the starter deck so you have a full playset of every single card in the starter deck. But what this card is doing is he has 2 really strong abilities. His first one is Security Tech plus 1, which is another really rare ability to be having on your purple cards, just because I think the only other purple card that has Security Tech plus 1 on level 6 is going to be Venom Myotismon. So the fact that Kreskurumon has it here is definitely really, really nice to see, because again, Security Tech plus 1 just allows you to do an additional security check, thus making it easier to close out the game even faster, because you're going to be doing multiple security damage in one swing. And then what's really good about this ability is, like I said before, you could pair it up with the Wergurumon, because you could sacrifice one of your Digimon to restand him to swing again, so that way you get an extra 2 security checks off of his other attack. So that's just really, really powerful synergy with the card, and what makes the synergy even stronger is the fact that he has a main ability of Digiburst 2, and his Digiburst 2 ability allows you to play 1 purple level 3 Digimon from your trash for free. So this is really good, because you could set up a really powerful play where you could Digiburst away your, let's just say, champion and rookie, put them into the trash, res the rookie that you just put into the trash, to then swing with Kreskurumon, then trigger Wergurumon's ability, sacrifice the card you just rezzed, to then restand and get a second swing with. So again, that just all combos to make him a very powerful card to be considering to play with, on top of which he even just combos with Anubismon, where you could just double Digiburst and spawn 2 level 3s to then just swing with right away because they have Rush. So there's just a lot of different things you could do with this ability, and Kreskurumon is just really strong for this ability, because it also allows you to trigger any of their on-play abilities, which is another really rare ability that purple has, is just allowing the cards that you res to use their on-play abilities. So all of this combined just makes Kreskurumon a very fantastic Digimon to be playing around with. The only unfortunate thing about the card is the fact that he evos for 4, so I definitely recommend that you basically just Digivolve all the way up into him from the raising, so that way when you bring him out, you can make some very powerful combo plays then and there. But regardless, Kress is just a very powerful Digimon to be working with. Next, onto the option cards, I'm going to be running 2 copies of Hell's Gate. So Hell's Gate is a really powerful option card to be playing with, because it has the nice main ability of deleting one of the opponent's level 6 or higher Digimon. So usually purple has a very hard time struggling on figuring out a good way to delete the opponent's high level Digimon, and we finally have Hell's Gate to help us interact with the opponent's high level Digimon. We had Trump Sword before, but Trump Sword is more expensive both at cost to play and monetarily, so I just felt like for what the deck is trying to do, because we're not really super synergy focused on options, Hell's Gate is just good enough for the time being. And then on top of which, Hell's Gate has a nice security ability of adding this card to our hand, so that way we could then figure out when we want to utilize it the best, because sometimes your security abilities could just whiff, so it's usually a smarter idea to have the card sitting in your hand for when the correct situation to use it occurs. And then the only other option of the deck is going to be 3 copies of Deathclaw. So Deathclaw is a really powerful option just because of how efficient this card is. So for the low play cost of 1, we get the very powerful main ability of deleting one of our Digimon to delete one of the opponent's level 4 or lower Digimon. So most of the time, we're just going to be trying to delete our rookies, because our rookies are the easiest things we could play and res. So basically, 9 out of 10 times, you're just going to be using this card to delete one of the opponent's blockers so that Kreskurumon can swing in, or you could utilize a whole bunch of your other Digimon that may or may not be on the field yet to just try to aggress onto the opponent. So this is just a really fantastic card for its removal ability, and it even has the nice set security ability of deleting one of the opponent's level 4 or lower Digimon, so when it's checked in the security, you still have the potential to delete a Digimon, which is still really, really good. Next, on to the Tamers, I'm going to be running two copies of Izzy. So, yes, I understand this is the Black Izzy from BT-04, but we're just using this card basically as a solid filler for a Memory Fixing Tamer. So, Memory Fixing Tamers are really important because they help make our plays that much more efficient, just because if our memory is ever less than 3, they'll just always hard set it to 3, but I feel like Izzy, compared to all of the other generic Memory Fixing Tamers, is one of the better ones, just because we could actually utilize his on-play ability to some degree, because his on-play ability allows us to check the top 3 cards of our deck, and then if all of the revealed cards are black, we gain a memory, but we don't care about that because none of the cards in our deck are black. We care about the fact that we get to place the cards on top of our deck in any order. So compared to, again, literally all of the other Memory Fixing Tamers we could be playing with on a budget, Izzy is just one of the better ones, because just fixing the top of our deck is still really, really valuable, even if we're not gaining the extra memory off of him. But keep in mind, this card is just filler for the time being, and this card really is supposed to be the Memory Fixing Mat, just because the Memory Fixing Mat is still just a very powerful card to be playing with for this style of deck. And then the only other Tamer I'm going to be running is two copies of the Starter Deck Mat. So the Starter Deck Mat isn't necessarily the best, it's not the worst, this is probably one of the cards that I would cut first, but he's still a pretty decent card just because he's a relatively efficient Tamer to be playing with, because he has a low play cost of 2, and on top of which, he still has a pretty decent ability where during your turn, when one of your Digimon is deleted, you get to suspend this Tamer to gain 1 memory. So this plus a Memory Fixer just allows you to easily try to play your Kreskurumon more efficiently, so that's already really good. You're already going to be super aggressive trying to utilize your Digimon to swing into the opponent's security anyway, and you have some sacrificial card set to try to delete your Digimon through card effects. So there's just a whole bunch of ways we could delete our own Digimon during our turn, so this Mat, even though he's not necessarily the best card in the world, he's still a pretty decent Tamer to be working with. And then purple just has so many other tech and tools that you could be thinking about. It really kind of allows you to create some really interesting and unique decks, all depending on what you want to play and what you want to be utilizing. So you could be playing more with the Inheritable of Ondelete, where you could run the Gabumon or the Tsukaimon. I think they're both really, really good. Tsukaimon just allows you to gain a memory, so pair that up on a blocker and they block and the blocker is deleted, then you'll gain a memory. Or you could do the same type of thing with Gabumon, where he'll allow you to draw 2, discard 1. So he's just acting as more consistency for the deck. Then, speaking of blockers, we also have another blocker we could be thinking about playing. So if you want to add a little bit of extra defense to the deck, then you're more than welcome to add in the extra blocker. But we also have some other really powerful inheritables. So Devimon, both having retaliation and giving retaliation, is really good because it makes whatever he's digivolving up into that much more annoying. On top of which, him just natively having retaliation means that he could act as some decent removal on his own. Or, if you want to just forego all of that, you could think about running just a very aggressive vanilla card. We could think about using Chimeramon just to act as another removal card, where we're just playing the card, deleting one of our own Digimon to delete one of their level 5s, so that way we have a removal card on each of the levels. I just feel like for what the deck is trying to do, he's not necessarily the best. Maybe as like a tech one of, just because we are more focused on trying to build up our Kress and utilize his Digiburst ability, but he's still pretty good to just think about because we could digivolve into Anubismon right after. So it's not like he's a bad card, it just he's a little bit clunky for what the deck wants. And Lady Devimon is also just another really fantastic card you could think about playing around with, but there are just a whole bunch of other decent megas that we could be running, all depending on what you could actually get your hands on and, again, what you actually want to build with. So you could think about utilizing the BT-02 Metal Garurumon, just because this card is still insane, because he has a nice when attacking ability where you get to play a purple level 3 Digimon from your trash for free. Or you could play something like Mastimon and do some different synergies there, where Mastimon's really good because you get a trash at the top of both players' security, so she's acting as some pseudo-burn, on top of which you could play a purple or yellow Digimon from your trash that's level 4 or less, so you could do some really interesting things with that ability too. Or if you just want another generically decent level 6, you could think about running Dandevimon, just because just digivolving up into Dandevimon is still very, very threatening for the opponent because of his ability where during the opponent's turn, once per turn, when a card is removed from your security stack, then you get to trash the top of the opponent's. So again, just more burn. And on top of which, he has a nice on-delete ability where the opponent gets to trash two cards from their hand. So that's just, again, really obnoxious for the opponent to be dealing with. And then we do have a level 7 you could consider playing. So Millenniummon, being currently the only level 7 we have access to, is still really good just because his when digivolving ability to tuck a Digimon on the opponent's field is really good because it'll bypass a lot of the on-delete triggers if they have any. And it's still just getting rid of a body on board, which is, again, always good. And he has a on-delete ability that basically allows him to replay himself as long as he had any Digivolution sources underneath. So, again, just another very powerful card you could consider. And then there's just a whole bunch of other options that you could be running. So you could be running more options from the starter deck, like Nailbone, or you could be running more options from other sets, like Night Raid. Or you could play a little bit more into the removal and run Heat Viper. Or, like I said, you could just run Trump Sword if you want a different option on removal. And then, as I mentioned before, Izzy is just supposed to be Matt, so if you could get your hands on some mats, then get some mats and run him instead of Izzy. And then you could kind of change and adjust your ratios of the deck accordingly. But I do think for what this deck is doing, it has a whole bunch of flexibility and versatility, and it definitely is a really powerful and interesting deck, all stemming from the starter deck and a BT-04. So, as I mentioned, there's just a ton that you could do, all depending on what you want to play. This is just what I felt like was really good for as cheap as I can get it, incorporating as many new cards as I possibly could. So that's all I really have for this video. As always, feel free to tell me your thoughts down in the comments below. And down in the description below are different ways that you could support me in the channel. So one of those ways is I do have a TCG Player affiliate link. So whenever you use that affiliate link to buy cards off of tcgplayer.com, then some of the money will go to supporting me in the channel. And on top of which, I also do stream over on twitch.tv/Zenitsu. So following and subbing is a good way to support me over on that platform as well. And on top of that, I also do make and sell playmats over on Overcard Gamers on Facebook. So whenever you buy one of my designs through them, then some of that money will also help go to supporting me in the channel. And as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content, and I'll see you in the next video.